Hi, myself Milan Patil. Welcome back to my channel. Today, we are going to learn about electricity. Before that, let us watch a video clipping of a news.
In Goa, strong winds uprooted trees and snapped power lines. Power supply remains disrupted in many parts of Goa. The electricity department is working overtime to restore the lines, but heavy wind is hampering their work.
So, my dear viewers, I'm sure most of my brothers and sisters had experienced this situation in past week. Our life has completely depended on electricity. We cannot even imagine our life without it. So, what is electricity? Let us learn more about it in our today's video. What is an electric current? In our previous video, we have seen importance of electricity. So, how will you define electricity? Or what is an electric current? To understand this, let us learn more about current first. Air or wind flowing causes air or wind current. In the same way, flowing water causes water current. So, flow or movement of anything is called current. Similarly, flow of electron is called electric current. Since electron possess a particular kind of charge, so we can say that flow of charge is called electric current. But why these electrons flow? Do they flow through all types of materials? We know that some materials allow electric current to flow through them, whereas some materials do not allow electric current to flow through them. We call such material as conductors and insulators respectively. Examples of conductors are metals. For example, silver, gold, copper, aluminium, iron. Some liquid also conduct electricity. For example, seawater, alcohol. Most of the non-metals are insulators. Some examples of insulators are glass, rubber, plastic, wood. Some non-conducting liquids are oil and sugar solution. Electrons flow through conductors, that is, it possess more free electrons, whereas insulators do not possess free electrons. But why do these electrons flow through conductor? What are electrons? All the things around us are made up of matter. Matter is composed of tiny particles called atoms. Let us try to understand what is an atom. Consider this solid object. We see that this solid object is made up of atoms, which are tightly packed together. Of course, we cannot see it with our naked eye, but with the help of electronic microscope, we will able to see its structure. We take one atom of this and try to analyze its structure. Then we will find something like this. Atom is made up of three subparticles. These are protons, neutrons, and electrons. Nucleus is made up of protons and neutrons. Electrons revolves around the nucleus in orbit. We have learned about Bohr's atomic model in our lower classes. This subatomic particle possess charges. Neutron have no electric charge. Proton have positive charge and electron have negative charge. In an atom, if the number of protons are equal to the number of electrons, then it is called neutral state of an atom. That is, it has no charge. Atoms try to attain stability by losing, gaining or sharing of electrons. Let us consider the Bohr's atomic model. This atom is a stable atom as number of electrons are equal to the number of protons. That is, it do not possess free electrons. Now let us see properties of these charges. Charges of opposite type are attracted together. For example, positive and a negative charge, whereas charges of same type repels each other, negative negative or positive positive charge. This is called electrostatic force, also called Coulomb's law. It is a force that operates between charges. Electrons closer to the nucleus feel a much more attraction to the center than those in the distant or outer orbit. The outermost electron of an atom are called the valence electron. These require the least amount of force to be free from an atom. Now consider a copper wire made of filled with countless copper atoms. The free electron of this atom move in random motion or haphazard motion. This electron moves due to electrostatic force, that is, electron repels each other. This free electron moves from one atom to another without disturbing their stability. This movement of electron is called drift movement. When we connect that wire to an electric cell, the energy transfer takes place from one cell to the electrons. The electron gets more energy, which makes them move continuously. This chain effect can continue on and on to create a flow of electrons called electric current. Electricity is defined as flow of electrons or flow of charge. Direction of electrons flow is from positive to negative terminal of a cell. By convention or assumption, the direction of flow of electric current is opposite to that of the flow of electron, that is, it is from positive to negative terminal of an electric cell. This is because when scientists started studying current, they thought in a wire current flow due to positive charge. It was later they found out that current flow is actually because of negative charge and not the positive charge. Also, current is caused due to concentration difference. That is, water current moves from higher pressure region to low pressure region. Similarly, air moves from higher pressure region to low pressure region. So therefore, electric current is nothing but flow of charge from positive high potential difference to negative low potential difference. Hence, the movement is in opposite direction. Electric current depends on the amount of charge. More the electrons or charge, more the electric current, and less the electron or charge, less the electric current. In our next video, we shall learn more about electric current, how to calculate electric current and types of current. Thank you.